guys and girls, welcome to Sketched, and in today's lesson, we will learn how to add objects in two-point perspective. In the last lesson, we saw the technique of how you can duplicate objects. As you can see here, you can duplicate objects in two-point perspective. And in this lesson, we are going to see how you can start building up on this. So, you know, when you're constructing, say, a scene or you're constructing a multi-leveled object, you will not have just one layer of these boxes or one layer of spheres or one layer of cubes. You may be required to have multiple layers of objects of different shapes and sizes. So in this lesson, we are going to take the first step towards that, and we're going to learn how to add objects on top of each other using the simple concepts of two-point perspective. So before we begin the lesson, as the short disclaimer that I always give you, the content I show here is something you can do using paper, pencil, and a ruler. You don't need to have advanced graphics tablets or softwares to get this done. You can even do this in your notebook with a pen if you want to, completely freehand. It's up to you. Okay, but for more accurate results, I recommend using paper, a ruler, and a pencil at the very least. Right. So with that out of the way, let us begin the lesson. So let me just take a new layer. And let me just get rid of the text. We need a bigger canvas for this. Okay, so as always, the first step that you have to do is you have to add, or you have to start with the horizon lines. So let me just make my horizon line. And I'm going to make it a little higher today because I want to show you how I can add a large number of objects. Right, so let me just create my horizon line. Right? Yeah, I've created my horizon line. Now, the next step that we need to do in two-point perspective is to set up the vanishing points. So we have two vanishing points to set up. Let us set them up right now. So I have one vanishing point over here. I will name it, say, VP1. And the second vanishing point is here, so I will call it VP2. Okay, now can I just reduce this? Yeah. Now, what you have to do is first create the initial layer of objects that you want. So the base of the structure is something that we have to create first. In this case, let us start by drawing one reference line. Right. Somewhere here, and a second reference line that converges to VP2. Let me just take it somewhere here. All right. Now, the next step is to start making the line. So let's make the height. Right. We'll make a height here. Converge to VP2, converge to VP1. Right, now I'll set up the rough dimensions of this object over here, and the other end could be this big. Right. Now, according to the rules of two-point perspective, whatever is to your left will converge to your right. So from this corner, I will take a line, join it here, and from this corner, I will take a line and converge it to VP1. All right, so here we have our first object. Okay, now what if I want to, add more objects like this? So basically, duplicate this as we saw in the last lesson. Let's duplicate this a couple of times. Okay, so first, you want to check where the center is. Right? From this center, we will draw one line to your VP2. Alright. And now from this corner, so corner A and corner B, we will create the framework for the next object. So I will take a line from A. Sorry about that. Take a line from A, pass it through the center and coincide with the reference line. Okay, and I will take a line from B, same procedure, and just join them. And from this corner, I will converge to VP1, and that's it. That's my second object. All right. So in the same way, we can make one more. I will name this C, and I will name this D. Right. So from C, from D, and join. And converge. All right. Okay, so now we have three objects that form the base of your structure. Now, what if I want to add a box on top of this, and that measures, say, two boxes? So I want a box that starts from here and ends here. Okay, how do we do that? Simple enough. We will take a different color for this. I think it will make it better. So first, you have the same sort of base here. So I will construct my base. Right? And I will now join VP2 and VP1. So it's like, it's basically like creating an object, just the base or the reference point changes. So currently it was, so in the first case, it was point B, which is nothing but the point of intersection between the two converging lines. But for the new object, it is going to be the corner. So extend B upwards, you get A, that's the top corner of the first object, and that becomes the base of the second object. Right. Now, I'm going to extend. This keeps changing color. Okay, so I'm going to make this converge first over here. Yeah, perfect. Now, as I said earlier, I want an object that starts from A and ends here, right? So the end point is already known, right? So I will draw a vertical from that end point upwards. Okay. And as always, it's anything on your right, facing the right, converges to the left. So from VP1 or vice versa, from the point to VP1, you can create this line, this reference line, right? So that forms a basic framework of one side of the object. And since the breadth is not going to change, right? I will just draw a vertical line here. And again, since it's on the left, it's going to converge to my right. Perfect. And there you go. That's an object on top of these two objects. So basically, this format continues upwards or even downwards if you are so keen. Right? You can create objects below it also. You can create objects that are, say, 1.5 boxes in length. So you could have the endpoint somewhere here. It doesn't matter. As long as you remember the principles, you're good to go. Now, how do you basically make sense of what you have made here? Let's see. When you create a product, or when you create the sketch of, say, a tall building or a tall structure, right? It is all going to be boxes or spheres or cylinders in the beginning. But you need to, for the final result, you need to start making sense of what you have made. So in this case, I will show you how you can finally define the object that you have drawn. Okay. And in the next lesson, we look at how you can shade it. But for now, you need to know how you add the object, so which we have seen. And once you've added the object, you need to know how to make sense of the whole thing. Because right now we have lots of boxes, lots of reference lines, you know, lots of stuff going on, right? So what I will do is I'll take a new layer. And I will take a very different color for the marker. Let me take this nice steel. And okay, so if you're on Procreate, you have a lot of these brushes that you can use. So you can use an inking brush, you can use a calligraphy brush, whatever strikes your fancy. Now, if you're on paper, using the paper, pencil, and ruler approach. If you want to highlight something, if you don't have a marker or sketch pen around you, you can just use your pencil, apply a little more pressure, and darken the final object. So that will give you a rough idea. If you have a marker close by, you can just grab the marker and follow what I'm doing here, right? So in this case, I'm going to take, let me see, this monoline looks good. And feel free to move around the paper as you wish. You know, you need to find it convenient. The angle should be convenient for you. So just orient it the way you want and let's begin. Right. So according to the brief that we set earlier, we added the object, but it did not say that the objects are different. So what I'm going to assume here is that we have created one big object with these specifications. So in that case, I will outline this, right? Because this is visible to me, right? This is visible to the eye. This edge will also be visible to the eye. So I will outline that. All right. Of course, this face will be visible to the eye. So let me just complete this face. This will be visible. All right. So what I will do is I will color it in. Sorry about that. And now for the top. Okay. Since you can see the top here, right? We can highlight that as well. So just go highlight the top. And if you want, you can color it in. Or if you don't want to color it in, you can just create a hatching like this. Or you can just create some sort of shading to let you know that, you know, there is a face up there. Okay, but I prefer coloring it in. Yes, it is going to look a little confusing to begin with, but it'll make sense soon enough. All right, so coming to this face, the face here to the right hand side, this till the end of the object is completely visible to us. And this line and this here. See, this forms the complete face. So if I color it in, you can see that we have, you know, a sort of 3D object. You can't see the 3D because we have not shaded it in, but I think you get the point. And finally, you can see that, you know, we have an object that is three boxes on the first level and just two boxes on the second level. So there is space. That one box space over here, right, that is going to be vacant. And here, if you want, you can just add a darker shade. Yeah. So if you see, we have created this sort of 3D object with barely any shading, right? But this is how you separate the object from all the reference lines. So the end result. So if you're presenting this to a client, or if you're presenting this to say anyone, your friends or your family or your colleagues, right? They don't want to see the reference lines and the approach that you've taken. So if you just make this go away, this is what they want to see. They have the canvas and you have the object. Now, of course, when you shade it, it will become a little clearer than what it is now. But this is what you want to show the client at the end of the day, because the end result is what they want. They don't really worry about how you get there. So this is how you get there. And this is the final outcome. And that's it for this lesson. If you want to practice this, you can try creating a base of, say, five objects on either side, and then add objects on top of that, and then on top of that, try to create a structure which has three layers instead of two. Right? It's up to you. You can do a lot of permutations and combinations. Even with just boxes, there are lots of things you can try out. Once we get to spheres and cylinders, you know, of course, we can combine them. We can have objects that have, you know, two cylinders, three boxes, one sphere on top, all those kinds of things. But for now, since you're focused on just the boxes, these are some exercises that you can do and practice either on your tablet or on paper, and just get the hang of what we're trying to do. So create an object, then highlight it and separate the final outcome from all the reference lines, so that way you understand what you have made. And you can always share your result with me on my social media pages or on our YouTube channel. It's up to you. And that's it, guys. This is how you add objects in two-point perspective. And until the next lesson, this is Sketch signing off. Thank you.